In the previous video, we just wrote all these LCD related functions that is useful for interfacing 16x2 LCD with our 889S52 microcontroller. And in this video, we are just going to write some programming logic for printing some text onto the 16x2 LCD. Let's get started. And initially what I'm going to do inside the main function is I'm just going to give the value 0 to all the pins of port 2 and port 3. So that can be done by writing port 2 equal to 0x00 and port 3 equal to 0x00. So initially I'm making the port 2 and port 3 pins 0. And then I'm just going to call this LCD init function for initializing the LCD. And coming to the while of one, so as I said, what I'm going to do is I'm just going to print SM Training Academy in this LCD. That is, I'm just going to print SM Training in the top row of the LCD and Academy in the bottom row of the LCD. So in the last lecture of LCD working explained, I just explained you the addresses of each and every columns and rows of this LCD, right? So the first row, first column starts with 0x80 and ends at 0x8f, right? And the second column starts at 0xc0 and it ends at 16th column 0xcf. So initially what I'm going to do is I'm just going to LCD command of 0x80 and I'm going to print the string SM training. So you can see this SM training is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, and 11. So I'm giving the 11 over here. So this 11 is nothing but the number of characters present in the string. So I'm going to the first row, first column by giving the command 0x80 to the LCD and I'm printing the string SM training. And then I'm just going to the second row, first column of the LCD by giving the command 0xc0 and I'm going to print the string academy. So this academy is having 7 characters. So I'm writing comma 7. So that's it. You can see the SM training will be printed in the first line and academy will be printed in the second line. Or you can also print single character by calling this function like this. Data of A. You can also do that. So I'm just going to second row, 15th column and I'm printing the character A. So that's all about the program. I'm just going to compile this program. For creating the hex file in this program, I'm just going to the options for target and here click on this output tab and check this create hex file checkbox and click on OK. Now click on this build icon for building the project or click on project build target. It is showing some error. Sorry, the enable name here is mismatched with the macro. It is capital N. I'm just pasting it over here. And that's it. I'm building the project again. You can see the project has been built with zero errors and zero warnings. Open the Proteus simulation software now. Double click this controller. And then click on this icon for loading the program file. And then go to the folder where you have stored the Keel project files. And inside the objects folder, you will find this hex file. Click on this and click on open. You can see the program file has been successfully loaded to the simulation microcontroller. Click on OK. And now when I play the simulation by clicking on the play button in the left bottom corner of the window, and you can see the SM Training Academy has been successfully printed as per our program along with the character A. So so this is what we expected in the program. We went to the first row, first column of the LCD, and we printed the string SM Training. And then we went to the second row, first column of the LCD, and we printed the string Academy. And then we went to the second row, 15th column of the LCD, and then we printed the character A using the LCD data function. You can see this is the development board that I'm going to use for demonstrating all the outputs that I get in my hardware. And here in my development board, you can see the ISP pinouts where you can connect the USB ASP programmer pinouts directly to this connector for programming this microcontroller or for uploading the hex file directly to this microcontroller. So the programmer that I'm going to use is USB ASP programmer, and I'm going to connect the pinouts of this programmer to my ISP programming lines available in my development board like this. And I'm going to connect this USB ASP programmer to my PC through USB cable like this. And the other end of my USB ASP programmer, I'm just going to connect that to the PC through USB cable. You can see the terminal connections of ISP programmer is this one. Reset is connected to reset pin of the ISP programmer, and clock is connected to clock, MISO to MISO, MOSI to MOSI, and VCC ground to the respective pins. So you can see all the pins are directly provided in my development board. Or if you are not having a development board, you can also build the circuit in a breadboard for uploading the hex to your microcontroller like this. So this is the pinout of this USB ASP programmer. I just want to connect the MOSI to the pin 6 and MISO to pin 7 and clock to pin 8, as well as the reset pin must be also connected to the pin 9, then the VCC must be connected to the pin 40, and ground must be connected to pin 20. In addition to this, you just want to provide a 11.0592 MHz crystal to this 18th and 19th pin of the microcontroller, and then you just want to pull this EA pin high so that you are indicating to the microcontroller that you are just going to use the internal ROM of the microcontroller. So using this circuit, you can also upload the hex file to this microcontroller even in breadboard. After the connection is done, open the program ISP software. The link for the software is provided in the description of this video. You can directly download it from there. Now you can see in this software, this program ISP icon is not highlighted. That means the programmer is not yet connected. Before that, you just want to choose the microcontroller that you are working on. So our microcontroller is 8089S52 that is being selected. But regardless of all the microcontrollers available, you just want to select the microcontroller that you are working on. So I'm choosing 8089S52. And then now when I connect my USB ASP programmer USB cable to my PC, you can see this icon is highlighted, which means that the programmer is connected to the PC USB port. Now for uploading the flash or the hex file to this software, you just want to click on this file tab and click on load flash. And go to the respective project folder where you have stored the project files, and there you can find the hex file inside this objects folder. And click on this hex file and click on open. Now you just want to check the required operations that needs to be done when you click on this auto button. So I need the microcontroller to be erased, as well as program the flash to the microcontroller, and then after programming I want the flash to be verified. So these three are the operations that I need. So I am just leaving these three checked. Other than that, I am not checking any other checkbox. And remember one thing, that while programming, the power from the USB ASB programmer is sufficient for the microcontroller. So you need not connect any external 5 volt signal to the microcontroller for powering up. Now for uploading the hex file, just click on this auto button. Now you can see the hex file is being downloaded to your microcontroller 8089S52. And the programming has been done. Now build the circuit to see the output in the hardware. So now you can see I have already made the circuit connections as per the schematic that I showed you before. Just before, now you can see this is the port 2 data lines of my microcontroller and this is the port 3. So 3.5, 3.6, 3.7 is connected to RS RW enable of the LCD, and these 8 lines, that is port 2 data lines P2.0 to 2.7, is connected to D0 to D7 of LCD. And regarding the backlight and the VDD, VSS and VEE terminals, as per this schematic, this development board is having the circuit. So I am not worrying about that. I am just going to directly connect the power supply for viewing the output. So now for powering up this development board, I am just going to use the 12 volt 1 amps adapter. I am just powering up this by using the socket available over here. And when I turn on the power supply, you can see the SM Training Academy has been printed on the LCD as per our logic. And as I said, this is the potentiometer that I am going to use for varying the contrast. So you can vary the contrast of the font available in the LCD using this potentiometer that is connected to VEE pin. So the circuit diagram I have already explained you and I have showed you before a few minutes. You can see when I vary or turn the potentiometer, the contrast of the font also varies in the LCD. This is the maximum and I am setting the correct font for viewer's point of view. So this is okay. So this is the output that I got in the hardware. See you in the next lecture. Thanks for watching.